Hello everyone, myself Pushpanjali Khaun, Assistant Professor of Environmental Science, Bibora College. My topic of presentation is Energy Flow in Ecosystem. The topic belongs to degree second semester under CBCS course. This presentation is prepared under the initiative of Zoological Society of Assam. Learning outcomes. From this discussion, students will come to know about basic understanding about ecosystem and source of energy, process of energy flow in an ecosystem, basic idea about the 10% law of energy flow, and how do ecosystems follow the laws of thermodynamics. Introduction. The first slide deals with the meaning of some of the important terminologies related to the topic. The ecosystem is an interacting system resulting from all abiotic and biotic components of the environment. Sir Arthur G. Tansley coined the term ecosystem in the year 1935. The abiotic component of ecosystem includes basic inorganic elements and compounds such as soil, water, oxygen, calcium carbonate, phosphates, and a variety of organic compounds. It also includes physical factors and ingredients like moisture, temperature, wind currents, solar radiation, rainfall, humidity, etc. The biotic components include all living organisms, that is plants, animals, and microorganisms present in the environmental system. Energy is defined as the capacity to do work. Thus, energy flow in ecosystem is the unidirectional flow of electromagnetic radiations of the sun and their conversion into biochemical energy from first tropic level, that is from producer to the subsequent tropic levels of the ecosystem. Process of energy flow in an ecosystem. Source and income of energy. The sun is the main source of energy in all the ecosystems. A fraction, that is about 1 by 50 millionth of the total solar radiation, reaches the Earth's atmosphere. The radiant energy of the sun travels through the space in the forms of waves. The energy reaching the Earth's surface consists largely of visible light, that is 380 to 740 nanometers, and infrared component. About 34% of the sunlight reaching the Earth's atmosphere is reflected back into its atmosphere. 10% is held by ozone layer, water vapor, and other atmospheric gases. The rest, 56%, reaches the Earth's surface. Only a fraction of this energy reaching the Earth's surface, that is 1 to 5%, is used by autotrophs for photosynthesis, and rest is absorbed as heat by ground vegetation or water. The solar energy is transformed into chemical energy by producers, that is by green plants and the photosynthetic bacteria. Fixation of energy by the autotrophs. The solar energy is converted to chemical energy by producer organisms through photosynthesis. The photosynthetic reaction for the same is carbon dioxide reacts with water in the presence of solar energy to form glucose, and it also releases oxygen into the atmosphere. Thus, solar energy goes to the producers. Energy beyond the autotrophs. From producers, energy goes to primary consumers through the food chain. In an ecosystem, the transfer of energy takes place through the food chain from one tropic level to the successive tropic levels. The transfer of food energy from one tropic level to successive tropic levels through different organisms is called food chain. This slide will explain the flow of energy at different levels of ecosystem. The first tropic level includes producers that convert solar energy into usable chemical energy through photosynthesis. As you can see in the diagram, the various producers are autotrophic plants, phytoplankton, etc. The second tropic level includes primary consumers like a herbivore that eats plants or algae, and hence they derive their energy from plants. For example, herbivores like protozoans, molluscs, crustaceans, fish, insects, etc. The third tropic level includes secondary consumers like a primary carnivore who gets their energy from herbivores. As you can see in the diagram, primary carnivores are owl, frog, fish, etc. Thus, The energy passes in an ecosystem from producers to primary consumers to primary carnivores to secondary carnivores and so on in a one-way direction. How the energy flows in units from sun through the various trophic levels in a food chain are depicted in this diagram, which was provided by Lindman in the year 1942. The modified form of Lindman's diagram is included in this presentation. Unidirectional flow of energy. The flow of energy in an ecosystem always takes place in one direction, that is solar radiation to producers, to primary consumers, to secondary consumers and to tertiary consumers. The solar energy that is captured by the producers does not revert back to solar input. As you can see in the diagram, the direction of the arrows is clearly indicating the energy passes to the herbivores, does not pass back to the autotrophs. Law of energy flow. During flow of energy from one trophic level to the next, there occurs a progressive decrease in energy level at its trophic level. 90% of energy is lost as heat due to different life processes like respiration, locomotion, running and other activities. Only 10% of energy passes from one trophic level to another trophic level. The diagram is clearly showing how the 10% law of energy flow works in a food chain. As you can see in the diagram, out of 10 lakh kilocalorie of solar energy, only 1%, that is 10,000 kilocalorie, is absorbed by producers. The primary consumer receives 10% of plant energy, that is 1,000 kilocalorie. Secondary consumers receives 10% energy of primary consumers, that is 100 kilocalorie, which is actually 1% of plant energy. In this way, the energy passes from one trophic level to another trophic level. The law of 10% was propounded by Lindman and supported by Odum. Laws of thermodynamics. The transfer of energy in an ecosystem is governed by two physical laws, the first and the second laws of thermodynamics. The first law of thermodynamics states that energy may be transformed from one form to another, but it can neither be created nor destroyed. Thus, the solar energy that comes from the sun is absorbed by green plants and converted into chemical or potential energy of food. This potential chemical energy is used by producers as well as by consumers. In this process, a greater part of energy is transformed into heat energy. The second law of thermodynamics states that energy transformation is never 100% efficient, as some energy is always dispersed into unavailable heat energy. Therefore, when the chemical energy accumulated by the plants is converted into kinetic energy by herbivores, when they consume the plants, some degradation of energy occurs through the conversion into heat. Similarly, further energy conversion and degradation will occur when the herbivore is consumed by primary carnivore and when the primary carnivore is eaten up by a secondary carnivore. For the clarification of your doubts, two books are suggested. You can also further contact me through my email ID, that is pushpanjali.count321@gmail.com. With that, I would like to conclude my presentation. Thank you so much.